Hello everyone, Assalamu alaikum and welcome to class of Umar Khan. Today we are going to cover this one of the most difficult topics of entire O-Levels Islamiyat syllabus, and that is stages of compilation of hadith. And these stages cover an outline of approximately more than 250 to 300 years. This topic is from section 2 of paper 2, which is history and importance of hadith, and a compulsory question comes from this topic and it carries 14 marks, which makes it very, very important. So compilation of hadith is stretched in these four timelines, you can say, or eras, or you can just simply divide these four into paragraphs. So the first one will be about during the lifetime of Prophet, peace be upon him. Then it will be covering during companions' time, and then successors and their successors, and then golden age of hadith compilation. So let's begin. Okay, in paragraph one, you are going to give this introduction that Prophet, peace be upon him, was a role model, and then you are going to give this reference. Then you are going to define hadith, that hadith is words, actions, and silent approvals or disapprovals of Prophet, peace be upon him. And then you will also talk about that why it was necessary to compile authentic hadith very briefly. So this paragraph one is going to be very precise and short, to the point. Then comes during the lifetime of Prophet, peace be upon him, what was the status of hadith compilation? Were they compiling hadith? Were they making written compilations during the lifetime of Prophet, peace be upon him? So prohibition of hadith writing. This could be a shock for some people that we are talking about written compilation of hadith, and question is starting from the prohibition that Prophet, peace be upon him, said, no, don't compile hadith. So definitely you are going to ask for the reason, and the reason is that Prophet, peace be upon him, thought about this possibility that Quran and hadith could get mixed, because, you know, companions who could read and write were very few in the beginning. As you all are aware, that when Prophet, peace be upon him, was born in Makkah in 570, just 17 people could read and write, and definitely not all of them converted to Islam. Although Prophet, peace be upon him, was motivating his followers to learn reading and writing skills and get educated, but you know, it takes time. So the writing force, the number of companions who could read and write, they were very few in the beginning, which is why Prophet, peace be upon him, asked them to focus on Quran writing, and he asked them to memorize hadith. So in this era, when hadith writing was prohibited, we find only official written documents which were dictated by Prophet, peace be upon him, not any hadith on any other topic in the beginning years. And you can write this list of these official documents. Peace document for Saraka bin Malik, you have to consult the topic of life in Makkah, migration to Yasrib, to know that what was this peace document and who was Saraka bin Malik. This was 622 AD. Then Charter of Medina, you all are very much aware that this was constitution of Medina after Muslims migrated to Medina. And the Treaty of Hudaybiyah, very famous, popular. Letters to emperors, Prophet, peace be upon him, sent multiple letters to different emperors, and they were written by Prophet's scribes and dictated by Prophet, peace be upon him, himself. So technically, these letters were also hadith, but they were official documents. And then Treaty with Christians of Najran is also available in written form. So this is page one. Moving forward, acha ab sawal hi paida hota hai ki if they were not writing hadith, then what they were doing about hadith? Focus on memorization and verbal transmission. They would just memorize hadith, and then they would just transmit it to other people verbally, and Arabs' memory was exceptional, which is why they would just memorize it directly. So there were study and pray circles in Mina in the beginning years of Makkah, you all are aware. Then Prophet, peace be upon him, shifted this teaching learning activity in house of Arqam. Hazrat Arqam was a companion who dedicated his house for teaching and learning, and this is considered the first school of Islam. And then when Prophet, peace be upon him, migrated to Medina, this place was the second school or shelter of Islam, and it was in Medina. The place is called Suffa, the bench. And the people who would stay here and learn hadith from Prophet, peace be upon him, they were Ashab-e-Suffa. So they were unemployed companions, they were very poor, and their expenditures and their food and water and other things were taken care by other companions, and they would just stay there and learn. And they were called Fraternity of Suffa. Hazrat Abu Huraira, a very famous companion, was also among Ashab-e-Suffa. So then Prophet, peace be upon him, also sent teaching delegations to different locations. They went to different tribes and different nomadic people and different cities, and they taught them hadith of Prophet, peace be upon him. Then finally Prophet, peace be upon him, granted permission to write hadith, but it was granted in the later years of Madani life. Some say it was 6th AH, some say it was 7th AH. And even a compilation was made upon orders of Prophet, peace be upon him. So we are actually proving that Prophet, peace be upon him, did not just give permission to write, he actually gave orders to make written compilations by saying, write for Abu Shah. What was that? Abu Shah Konte. Actually, when Prophet, peace be upon him, delivered farewell sermon, a companion, a new convert from Yemen named Abu Shah, came to Prophet, peace be upon him, and said that a lot of people wanted to attend this farewell sermon from Yemen, but they could not because of some reason. So if you can give me the written version, the text of this sermon, that would be very good. I would spread it everywhere across Yemen. So Prophet, peace be upon him, called upon one of his scribes and said, write for Abu Shah. So this was written for Abu Shah Yamani, and he took it with him. Okay, then we are going to mention the names of companions, very few names of companions with maximum transmissions. These are the people who memorized and transmitted maximum number of hadith among male companions, and among all of them actually, Hazrat Abu Huraira is the companion who transmitted maximum number of hadith, and they were 5374. You need to remember this number. And then Hazrat Aisha, among female companions, he transmitted 2210. Then we have Anas bin Malik, Jabir bin Abdullah, Abu Sayyid Khudri, and Abu Abdullah bin Umar radiallahu anhu. Okay, compilations and notes compiled during the lifetime of Prophet, peace be upon him. Okay, so in this one, we are going to mention these three documents, or three, you can't say books, these were not official books, these were just personal notes. The most popular one is Sahifa-e Sadiqa, the truthful script written by Abdullah bin Amr bin As. This is considered one of the most earliest compilations of hadith. And then a booklet containing hadith regarding blood money and retaliation and other legal matters. It was compiled by Hazrat Ali, and he would carry it with him all the time inside the cover of his sword. And the third booklet was about prayer, zakat, purification and administrative laws. It was compiled by another companion, Amr bin Hazm radiallahu anhu. And then finally, demise of Prophet, peace be upon him. So there is a lot of information, a lot of data during the lifetime of Prophet. So you can even divide this, you know, half page and then this full page and then this half page into two paragraphs. So aap isko paragraph 2 or paragraph 3 bhi bana sakte ho. Paragraphing is totally up to you. Paragraphing should be there. Kitne paragraph? Cambridge is not concerned. Theek hai, unhone koi official pattern nahi diya ki you have to make 3 or 5 or 7. Okay, it's totally up to you. You have to break the data and you have to facilitate the examiner. Your answer presentation should be very good. Okay, people, we are moving forward. After the demise of Prophet, peace be upon him, Prophet, peace be upon him, died in 11th AH. And the last companion, Anas bin Malik, died in 92 AH. So this era from 11 to 92 AH, approximately 81 years, this is companion's era. So, is time mein kya kya hua? Conquest of Rome, Persia, Northern Africa and other areas. So, companions took this opportunity and they felt that there is extra responsibility upon their shoulders, and they traveled. And by their traveling, some new learning centers emerged. And these learning centers were Makkah, Medina, to definitely Kufa, Basra, Damascus and other important cities, where these companions conducted study circles, and they would spread Quran and other teachings of Islam along with hadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay, there is a mosque. Ab hum ye prove kar rahe hain ke companions traveled to spread hadith. So we have like some evidences that there is a mosque in China built by companions. There are graves of companions in Sri Lanka and even our province, Sindh, Pakistan. And even I have heard this, that a companion's name is Hazrat Hammad radiallahu anhu, and he was companion of Prophet, peace be upon him, and he came to Sindh to preach Islam. Okay, then we will talk about the efforts of mothers of faithful, and among them especially Hazrat Aisha, who played very important role in spreading of Prophet's hadith to female companion in particular and overall in general. So a lot of hadith compilers of this era were direct or indirect student of Hazrat Aisha, and the most popular student of Hazrat Aisha was Urwa. This name is important, you have to mention this name. Then there are a few more names, notable companions who made compilations or personal notes during this time, and they were Hazrat Abu Huraira, Ubadah bin Samit, Samra bin Jundub and Abdullah bin Abbas. Okay people, moving forward, next paragraph is about era of successors and their successors. This is from 92. This is the demise of last companion Anas bin Malik, and it goes up until 200 AH. Achha, this is not a hard and fast. Theek hai, ye thoda sa overlap karta hai. This is just, you know, approximate. Okay. So, mostly verbal transmission and personal notes making was taking place for almost 9 decades. Yani ke 11th AH se 92 AH tak. People were just focusing on verbal transmissions and personal notes. Finally, in 99 AH, something new happened. Aur wo kya tha? Finally, government involved. And the caliph who paid attention towards this, his name was Umar bin Abdul Aziz. You must remember that Umar bin Abdul Aziz is different from Umar bin Khattab. Umar bin Khattab, the second caliph, Hazrat Umar Farooq رضی اللہ عنہ, he got martyred in 24 AH, and this is 99 AH. So, yeh bahut baat ke hain. And he was among Umayyads. But that is a topic of history. We'll talk about it some other time. So, Umar bin Abdul Aziz, as a caliph of the whole Islamic empire, he sends a letter in 99 AH to the governor of Medina, in which he demands that gather scholars and compile hadith. Okay, and we will provide resources. Imam Zuhri, a very popular and famous scholar, was designated in charge of this process. And Imam Zuhri says that we compiled a lot of hadith and sent them to Damascus to be printed and spread across Islamic empire. So this work was taking place with good pace, and things were getting better with every single passing day. Lekin ek disaster hua that Hazrat Umar bin Abdul Aziz got martyred. Kyun kaise? This is once again topic of history. You don't have to mention this here. Unfortunately, after his demise, the supervision got affected, and some say that it ended. But still, in this era, some amazing work of compilation of hadith took place, and the most leading compiler was Imam Malik. And he compiled a very important book, Muwatta. Some people believe that wo jo Sihai Sitta hain, jo six authoritative books hain, Muwatta is one of them. Some scholars even claim that Sihai Sitta nahi hai, Sihai Saba hai. Yani ke there are 7 authoritative books, and Muwatta is the most senior and the oldest one. Then Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal is also very popular. He compiled a very lengthy book of hadith, Musnad Ahmad. Then there is Hasan Basri, Sufyan Sauri, and Ayyub al-Sakhtiani. Okay, so this is era of successors and their successors. Then comes golden age, people. It was after 200 AH. Iska koi ending time nahi hai. Most probably like 50 to 60 years, or some say that 100 years tak ka time hai. Isme kya kya hua? Special focus on quality instead of quantity. Nika, we have to find quality hadith, okay? अच्छा क्वालिटी हदीस क्या होती है भाई सारी हदीस क्वालिटी होनी चाहिए सब बातें अगर आपसे सलम ने कही हैं नहीं मसला ये कि सब बातें आपसे सलम ने नहीं कही देयर वर सम ज़ईफ हदीस एज वेल एंड फैब्रिकेटेड हदीस एज वेल सो दे हैड टू फाइंड अ मैकेनिज्म टू ऑथेंटिकेट हदीस टू चेक कि ये जो अरबिक टेक्स्ट हमारे सामने आ रहा है ये हदीस है भी कि नहीं है सो टू फॉर दिस पर्पज दे came up with the idea of checking isnad, which is chain of transmitters, and matan, which is text of hadith. And this is a separate topic. You must have done it, and
I'm going to upload a video about this topic as well. Okay, so great work on Asmaur Rijal. Asmaur Rijal is also connected with Isnad, aur ye Isnad Matan ke topic mein discuss hota hai. अभी मैं आपको सिर्फ इतना बता सकता हूँ कि अस्माउर रिजाल इज अस्मा मीन्स नेम्स, रिजाल मीन्स पीपल. इन दिस बायोग्राफीज ऑफ स्कॉलर्स ट्रांसमिटर्स ऑफ हदीस वर कंपाइल्ड इन बुक्स, सो वी कैन चेक दैट दीज ट्रांसमिटर्स जो ये कह रहे हैं कि हमने ये हदीस इससे सुनी, उसने उससे सुनी, उसने उससे सुनी, उसने आपसे सलम से सुनी, ठीक है. तो इस पूरी लिस्ट को हम वेरीफाई करें कि ये लोग रिलायबल भी हैं कि नहीं है, इनकी मेमोरी ठीक है, इनका कैरेक्टर ठीक है, एक्सेट्रा. And then as a result of Isnad and Matan and Asmaur Rijal and everything, classifications of hadith emerged. Pehle every hadith was hadith, but now people started considering sahih, hasan, daif and maudu. And then finally the most important thing you have to remember this list, 6 authoritative books of hadith were compiled, also called Sihah-e-Sitta. And these books are considered the most authentic book of hadith till date. Sahih al-Bukhari, written by Muhammad bin Ismail, contains 7257 hadiths. Sahih Muslim, written by Muslim bin Hajjaj, contains 9200 hadiths. Sunan Abu Dawood, written by Sulaiman ibn al-Ashras, contains 4800 hadiths. Sunan al-Nasai, written by Ahmad bin al-Shuaib, contains 5700 hadiths. Sunan al-Tirmizi, written by Muhammad bin Isa, rahmatullahi alayhi, and contains 4400. Sunan ibn Majah, written by Muhammad bin Yazid, and contains 4341 hadiths. So this is the end of this topic, compilation of hadith. And at the end, you can just write 2 or 3 lines for conclusion that this is the complete outline, which started from Prophet, peace be upon him, himself prohibiting the compilation of hadith, and all the way it ended on this, when these 6 authoritative books were compiled by some greatest scholars, and they put their maximum possible efforts to ensure that upcoming generations get authentic and true hadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay people, so that's all from my side. Inshallah, I'll be uploading more videos on different topics. Stay tuned. Thank you very much. Take care of yourselves. Allah Hafiz.